Dear God, please help me. I come to you in my time of need. I need your wisdom, your guidance, and your strength. Help me to do what is best in this situation. Help me to do what is right. I just don't know what to do. And I need you now more than ever.
I need love. You need love. Give me love, and I'll give you my love.
Say 30's the new 20, and 20's the new 30, should I guess? Makes sense, cause 15-year-olds seem 20, and 25-year-olds seem 10. I used to drink away my paycheck, celebrate the mistakes I hadn't made yet. Our generation isn't the best on safe sex, we forget the latex, becoming Planned Parenthood patients. Am I subconscious? Telling me stop it.
This is an issue that you shouldn't get involved in. So let me pitch a scenario to you. You have a woman who prematurely gives birth to a baby at 22 weeks. Then, right next to her, you have a woman who is pregnant with her baby for 40 weeks. You mean to tell me that the premature baby is more of a human than that of the one that the woman was carrying?
But you can't just look at it that way. You also have to take into consideration the kinds of homes both children are being brought into, and if the parents are even fit to sustain proper living conditions. Why would you want an unwanted child to be born into instant poverty?
But you couldn't have possibly known what type of life that child would have had.
Actually, statistics show that in the years since Roe vs. Wade, crime rates have dropped significantly. So while we don't know for sure, the signs do suggest that the majority will follow the same path.
Well, either way, they're still a person. They should be given the same rights that we all do.
But it's my body. It should be my choice.
But it's God's child. You shouldn't murder it.
Well, look, even excluding religion, the argument of my body, my choice is invalid because that unborn child has a body that it doesn't get a say in what happens to it.
Well, technically, during the first trimester of the fetus, it can't sustain any form of life whatsoever without the support of its mother. And pretty much at that point, it's an extension of the mom. And you can't exclude religion from this debate because that's pretty much why this debate even exists.
All right, guys, good job. I heard a lot of great arguments about both sides, and y'all obviously did your research. Like always, we're going to revisit this topic at the end of the week. And at that time, if you decide you wanted to switch your position, you're more than welcome to do that.
Hey, what's up?
How'd it go?
It was interesting. Definitely a lot of opinions.
Are you going to Planned Parenthood afterwards?
I wanted to, but I have to type in English paper. It's due tonight, so.
Okay. Also, I want you to say hi.
Cool.
All right, guys. Let me remind you one more time.
I'm not here to protest. I'm not here to argue with anyone. We're just here to pray and to speak to people who are willing to let us.
Dear God, please help her through this rough time.
Becca!
That's my child too. And if you don't want to take care of him, then I will.
Are you going to carry this for 9 months? Are you going to take the judgment and the ridicule? I've made up my mind, Brady. You're only making this harder on yourself.
Can I pray for you?
Yeah, sure.
Dear God, please help this poor child, and I'm about to kill myself.
Hey, are you alright?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Are you pregnant?
No, I'm...
Hey, I got your text. What's up?
I'm pregnant.
What?
I said I'm pregnant. I'm 2 weeks late. I took 3 tests last night. They all came out positive. I haven't told my parents yet. I thought you maybe want to do it together.
You can't keep that.
What?
You are not going to keep that, right?
Why not?
We're the first in our families to make it past high school. I mean, we already have our future planned out, and this is not a part of the plan, Jennifer.
I saw a man practically begging his girlfriend yesterday not to have an abortion, yet that's your first option?
Look, I'm thinking about what's best for us, okay? And you even said you're glad you're not like your mom, who got pregnant with you in high school, and you're glad you can actually go off and make something of your life. If we have this child, we're never gonna get out of this town. It's just gonna be an endless chain that will never be broken.
I can't believe you. After everything you claim you stand for, I thought you'd be the one person I count on to be my support.
I look, sorry, okay?
No, stay the hell away from me.
Jin! Jin!
I mean, come on. You don't think there's like the slightest chance that they exist?
No, there's only one universe, that's it.
But what about like black holes and...
Shh, I've got something for you.
What? Is that... Where'd you get that?
Your mom gave it to me. Should I open it or...
I got in.
That's great, now we'll be there in the fall.
This is great, we can get out of this town and we can go to college together. What's so funny?
I love you.
Joseph.
Huh?
Pay attention.
Oh, yeah,
right. Sorry. What's your problem,
man, huh? What? You got enough balls to get my sister pregnant, then you better have enough to take care of her. You can't just make mistakes like this and brush it off like nothing happened. You gotta man up and take responsibility. You disgusting pig.
You alright?
Yeah.
Did anything happen with you and Joseph?
I don't want to talk about it.
I'll give you a space. Just know that I'm here if you need anything. Alright? I'm always here for you, sis.
Jin, I...
It's fine. I get it.
No, Jin, look.
You made your point. You don't want it. Well, you know what?
Either.
Will you listen to me?
You've done. I swear you better hope that she makes it out of this.
Come on, skin.
Miss Salamanca. I'm Dr. Udonka. How are you doing?
Better, but how's...
Well, the embryo's still alive. Honestly, I don't know how. But there's still a chance of complications in the later stages of development. But I just have to keep an eye on that.
Well, we actually weren't going to be there.
Well, right now I can't do anything. You guys can talk as long as you want and just give me a call whenever you make a decision.
Hey, everything's gonna be all right.
All right, guys, so you've got a whole week to further deepen your arguments. Did anybody want to switch sides at this point? Interesting. Why is that?
America's policy in regards to abortion is that it's legal for anyone who wants it and it's beneficial to them. I think sometimes we get so caught up in our pre-registered ideologies that we forget to realize that it's a decision that has been made 125,000 times every day in our country alone by various women in various situations. And for those who haven't been affected by it, it's kind of hard to see from their perspective.
Multi-parallel universes.
What does that even mean?
I look, just try and picture it like this. For every choice we make, another universe is created in which we made a different one. So, somewhere out there, there's a version of us where we live an entirely different life based off of one decision.
Does every choice we make really have that big of an impact, though?
Some maybe more than others, but haven't you ever wondered how differently your life would have been if you had went down a different path?
Yeah, but there's no such thing as a multi-parallel universe.
I mean, come on. You don't even think there's the slightest chance that they exist?
No. There's only one universe. That's it.
Contemplating just who I could have turned out to be. If I'd have stayed on with her, what would amount to me? If I had looked and ain't found what I had found in me. I mean, inside, would they love me? Never look down on me. They say, you know, if you loved her, well, then you would have stayed. You could have made a perfect pair that people wouldn't trade. Trade for nothing I did, though I had to chase it. Face it, I wasn't born to live a life basic. They say you turned your back on us just to go and be an artist. What's a promise anyway when someone breaks it? I bet he finally gets a shot and then he wastes it. I bet he don't come back for us when he makes it. Old friends I grew up with, the girl I fell in love with. Love or hate me, depending on how you judge it.